Well, there are two undefeated teams as we move into the Week 4 games in NHC play that will be clashing this Friday night. It's New Haven at Carroll. Carroll hasn't been tested as much.
Neither team has.
Well, that's true, but Carroll has put up 70 last week against Norwell. They put up 55 against Goshen. They've been dominant, but this will be by far their biggest test of the season. New Haven, they haven't really been tested. Woodland, we thought, might test them in week two. That turned into a blowout. So what do we know about these teams going in, and what are going to be some of the big keys on Friday night at Dean Gorsuch Field?
What we know about these two teams are they are mirror images of each other. Bulldogs have scored 164 points this year. Chargers have scored 166. New Haven's winning by an average of 54-14. Carroll's winning by an average of 55-7. But Carroll has a running game, right? Because they got Drew Tranquil, who's run for 409 yards and 11 touchdowns. Well, no, because New Haven has Arias Vasquez, who's run for 397 yards and 10 touchdowns. Both have playmakers in Jordan Hogue for New Haven, Justin Tranquil, who can impact the game for Carroll. This is just down the line, it's an evenly matched game. Both have good quarterbacks in Chandler Boggs for Carroll and Vance Shear for New Haven. And so it's just going to be an epic matchup. In a game like this, I really don't know who to go with, so I'm going to go with the home team and say Carroll wins barely. However, my colleague at the New Sentinel, Blake Sebring, says no, New Haven pounds the ball. He's seen them a couple of times, and they have three guys who can run the ball. They run the flex bone offense, so they can put guys out on the wings who can get some misdirection and do some things. Blake thinks that they're going to get a slight lead and just run the ball at Carroll and pound them. But even if New Haven gets a lead, we've seen Drew Tranquil's one play away from going a long way. And not just like, well, he can get 24, 26 yards on play. He's getting 70 yards on some plays, 55 yards on plays. So as long as Carroll is within striking distance, they got a shot. But I think Carroll wins the game. Blake Sebring thinks New Haven. We'll argue back and forth on that.
You're right that they're very, in terms of their image, very much a mirror image of each other, because you do have the one two-sided star in Drew Tranquil on Carroll's team. He can play offense, he can play defense. Jordan Hogue, who is starting to pick up more on the recruiting circuit, he has been great defensively and offensively.
Yeah.
As far as the quarterback position goes, you mentioned both of the guys. Is that going to be where this game is determined, or do you think it's going to be whoever makes the first or last stop defensively that'll ultimately determine how this game goes?
Well, with those two quarterbacks, what they are, they're not spectacular quarterbacks. It's not like the old Zach Terrell-James Kanapke battles or anything like that. But Shearer and Boggs are effective. They do their jobs, and they don't hurt their teams. They just run the offense, and they take what the defense will give them. I think this could come down to which team makes a critical turnover in the second half. That could be the difference, because when everything else, special teams, offense, and defense are so evenly matched like this game is, it's going to be smarts and taking care of the football that end up being the key to this. So a critical turnover second half will end up maybe swaying this game one way or the other. And like I said, I like Carroll being at home. It's homecoming. It's going to be a great game either way, but in a close one, I'll go with the home team.
It will be our highlight zone game of the week, so we will have plenty of coverage of that game. Another game, although it will be taking place out of the area, is very much interesting to everyone in the area, will be Snyder at Penn. This is a matchup we've seen in the playoffs the last couple of years. Two very vaunted programs going head-to-head. They're both 3-0 this season. Tom, what do you think is going to be the big key when we see the Panthers take on the Kingsmen this coming Friday?
Well, unfortunately for the hometown team, I think that it's going to go the Kingsmen's way. They are really dominant this year. They've only allowed one touchdown this year for the whole year, 2.3 points per game. Snyder, if they have any chance at all, any chance, which I think it's a slim pickings on this. I don't think they do, but any chance at all, they're going to have to establish a run game with Jabri Bramley and Alex Roy and Neandre Billingsley. They're going to have to be able to run the ball effectively, take the pressure off young quarterback Colton Painter. If they have to throw the ball a lot with Painter against that Penn defense, like I said, has only given up one touchdown all year, they're going to be in big trouble, and Penn can roll. Penn played a really good Elkhart Central team last week, beat them 49-0. And so I think it's going to be a long night for Snyder. I was up there a couple years ago when they went up there and had a long night. But Fort Wayne was 2-0 against Penn last year between Carroll and Snyder. So maybe Snyder can shock the world and knock off Penn. But I think if they're going to struggle to run the ball, they're going to have to throw the ball with Colton Painter against a really tough defense, and they're going to be in trouble.
I know when we were talking off camera, you were excited about the ACAC matchups this week. Yeah. But one of the cross-conference matchups this week will take place between an SAC team and an ACAC team. Kind of an interesting matchup, I think, because of where both teams are at. Bishop Lures at Leo. I never would have thought Bishop Lures would open a season 0-3. And Leo's doing what Leo does. They open conference play with a 42-0 win at Adams Central last week, or at home, excuse me, last week. So talk a little bit about what we can expect this Friday night when Leo and Lures play.
Well, I'm going to sound like a hypocrite here. I'm going to tell you, on one hand, Lures is not as bad as its 0-3 record. And everybody's jumping on Lures. It's the worst record, worst start since 1965, which is not in my lifetime, and I'm old. But Lures is better than what their record indicates. Having said that, they're going to end up being 0-4 after this week. Leo is really dominant on both sides of the ball. Lures just does not have the ability this year to hang with Leo. They don't have the depth. They don't have the talent. They don't have the size, strength, speed, any of that. It's going to be a long night for Bishop Lures. They're going to be 0-4 at the end of it, and everybody's going to say, see, Lures is really bad. Lures is not really bad. They're just young and inexperienced, and they're this close to being 2-1 right now. They've had two really tough games in the last 2 weeks. Yes, Snyder was a bad game where they turned it over seven times. Leo will be a bad game where they'll struggle. But they're really, really close to being 2-1 instead of 0-3. So they're not nearly as bad as their record indicates. But that's not going to help them this week.
Yeah, two straight overtime losses, one at home, one on the road to some quality SAC teams. So Lures 0-3, but could easily be 2-1.
Yeah.
Other games that you're really having an eye on, I know that Dwenger versus Northrop now is something a couple weeks ago we thought would be a cakewalk. That's going to be more of a contested game than we had originally thought. And then some of those ACAC games that you really like.
Well, Adams Central at Garrett's going to be a really good matchup. That's going to be worth your money because both teams can play really good defense, and they can also score some points as well. I like Garrett's ability to run the ball. They have a lot of size up front, and they don't have Todd Fricke or the superstar running back, but they can run the ball effectively. And so that's going to be a good matchup. Heritage at South Adams, and you know, a lot of people were down on Heritage when they lost early on this season. They've really bounced back. They had a good win against Woodland last week. And so I think Heritage is much better than people originally thought. And a great game out of the ACAC and the NECC is Angola, surprising 2-1 and 2-0 in the league, going to Lakeland, which is a traditional power in that league. They're undefeated again this year at 3-0. So can Angola continue their positive momentum and maybe shock the NECC and get a win at Lakeland? That'll be a good matchup as well.
Yeah, Lakeland coming off a nice win at Central Noble last week. You mentioned they're always good, and Angola has really started to put it together second year under head coach Josh Sheff. So we'll have to see what kind of progress they can make against a traditional conference power this Friday night. Of course, that's something we can talk about next Monday on a new edition of Inside the Zone. But for this week, he's Tom, I'm Glenn, and we'll see you then.